This tutorial shows how easy it is to convert your existing E1000 EXTER application to iX Developer. E1000 EXTER was introduced in 2005 and has achieved great popularity during the years on the market, thanks to ease of use, solid functionality, and reliable operation. Now, key components have become difficult to source and the technical risk of maintaining the E1000 EXTER product platform has become too large. The replacement of the E1000 EXTER is the X2 HMI series, released in 2016. The X2 series is the next generation of HMIs from Beijer Electronics. Six product families combine great design with strong performance to power your HMI solutions. Create smart, integrated solutions boosted by iX HMI software and Warp Engineering Studio. We will now convert an E1000 project to iX Developer. During the conversion, we will introduce tools that will simplify and speed up the conversion process. Start by selecting Import Project. Click on the Browse button and select the E1000 EXTER project that should be converted. Next step is to select which panel the application should be converted to. You can find a complete conversion table on the Beijer Electronics website. Click on Products and select End of Life Guide EXTER and E1000. Select EXTER E1000 Migration Table. In this case, the original project was developed for E1070. The suggested migration panel is X2 Pro 10. Back in iX Developer, we select X2 Pro 10 and click on the Finish button. A dialog will appear, allowing us to select how the conversion should be carried out. In general, it's recommended to enable all options. The conversion tool will detect if the E1000 EXTER project contains function keys and ask if a special key template screen should be included. When selecting No, the project will be converted to a touch application. If you select Yes, a key template screen will be applied to the converted application. The key template screen contains buttons that emulate function keys, picture objects that emulate LEDs, text objects that present the content of the text strips, and button objects that allow the operator to navigate in the application and acknowledge alarms. We select Yes. The conversion will now proceed. Next step is to select which drivers should be used in the converted iX application. The original E1000 EXTER project used the MC protocol driver. This must also be selected for the iX developer application. The conversion dialog displays the progress of the conversion, as well as the number of errors, warnings, and information messages that have been detected during the conversion. The conversion is now finalized. Click on Open Log to review the generated warning messages. The converted application has one error, 37 warnings, and 32 information messages. It's recommended to show all messages. This provides the best overview of which function or screen a message relates to. The warnings in the beginning and end of the log file are mainly about E1000 EXTER functions that have not been converted. It's therefore necessary to investigate if the feature was used in the E1000 EXTER project, and if so, implement it in iX Developer. The first blocks were converted without errors and warnings. However, when converting the analog objects block, the numeric table object was discarded, and the analog fill was converted to an ellipse. In the digital objects block, the digital fill object was also converted to an ellipse. Click on OK. The application will now be generated and opened. A conversion manual can be found on our website. It explains the conversion process and how to handle the most common issues. Scroll down and select Convert your old HMI application to iX and click on the Learn More button. Click on the link and select the manual to open it. The document is divided into three main parts. First, how to prepare the original project before the conversion. Secondly, the steps needed to convert the project to iX Developer. And finally, what to consider, review, and correct after the conversion has been carried out. If we click on a function such as multi-language, the relevant chapter will be opened and you will find information about typical things to consider and implement. For multiple language, this means that the languages must be renamed and indexes updated. By searching in the document, we can find information about how to handle the most common issues. Let's search for a couple of errors and warnings that were mentioned in the log file. The error message indicates that the analog numeric table object has been discarded during the conversion. This can be mitigated by creating a series of analog numeric objects instead. Finally, we search for the analog digital fill warning. The manual suggests several approaches for how to finalize the conversion of the analog digital fill objects. We will now correct a few of the warnings that were identified in the log file. We will start with configuring the controller. Click on the tags icon in the Project Explorer. Open the Controllers tab and click on Settings. In the Stations tab, it's possible to define the IP address that the driver should connect to. In this example, 192.168.1.40. If you are unsure about settings or addressing, then the driver's help file can be accessed by clicking on the Help button. Each communication driver has a unique help file. It contains information such as release notes, addressing, and troubleshooting. Click on OK to accept the new driver settings. We will now correct the multiple languages configuration, as suggested in the conversion manual. Click on Multiple Languages. The first language can be deleted since these texts are used in the default language. We also select a valid language. In this case, we select Swedish. Last step is to adjust the language indexes so that they correspond to the indexes used in the original project. We will now add the missing numeric table object to the Analog Objects screen. Right-click on an existing analog numeric and select Copy. Right-click again and select Paste. Resize the object and make sure that it's connected to the correct tag. Right-click and select Create Series. Type in the number of columns and rows that should be auto-generated, in this case, 3 and 4. Click on OK. Finally, we will review one of the fill objects that were converted to an ellipse during the conversion process. Select the Digital Objects screen. Open the object browser and choose the ellipse object. One way to implement this fill functionality is to resize the object, select Shape Outline, followed by More Thicknesses. Type in an appropriate thickness, in this case 35. This will give the ellipse a filled appearance. The ellipse is already configured with color dynamics according to the settings in the original E1000 EXTER project. When the tag value is 0, the color will be red, and when the tag value is 1, the color will be green. These are a few examples of necessary actions after a conversion. You will need to review the log file and correct all of the necessary warnings and errors. It's always recommended to download the application to the target and verify the functionality as well as the graphical appearance before making any further adjustments of object size or placement in iX Developer. Start downloading the application by clicking the Download button. Select the target that the application should be downloaded to and click on Download. The application is now successfully downloaded and running in the X2 Pro 10 panel. After completing the download, all functionality must be fully tested in the same way as when developing a project from scratch. This means reviewing and testing all screens, buttons, I/O, etc. to make sure that the conversion has not changed the behavior of the application and that it fulfills all requirements. You might need further editing and refinement of the application before it fully matches your requirements. To sum up, with the help of iX Developer's built-in conversion tool, it's easy to quickly convert your existing E1000 EXTER projects to iX Developer. Even though the conversion is not one-to-one, you will save many hours of engineering compared to building a complete HMI application from scratch. And remember, iX Developer includes many new and modern features compared to E1000 EXTER. So take the opportunity to review what iX Developer is capable of and take your HMI application to the next level.